This is my boy Josh. This is a rifle my dad bought back from Japan at World War II. I made a short video giving this to him, and many of you badmouthed him because you didn't think he acted like he was excited enough. And I didn't badmouth none of y'all in return, but he's a Marine and he knew it was coming, and
we talked about
he didn't jump
time.
Up and down and act like, oh, I'm surprised and happy, because he wasn't surprised, but he was happy. Anyway, we've come to an interesting point. Many of you know Onelonelyfarmer. Well, maybe I shouldn't put this out there because he might not want it out there. So I'll make the video, but we may never put it up, okay?
He and I have actually talked about it. So a discussion was had by him and I about how impressed he was with the story of this rifle and how he really liked it. And my wife wanted to send him and Teresa a care package for taking care of us and for saving your life from the flood.
That's kind of a big deal.
That's kind of a big deal.
Yeah.
If you guys haven't seen it yet, check it out. It's pretty incredible.
Yeah.
Flash flood from Hurricane Ida. Had Dad stuck in Frenchtown, New Jersey in a flood. And at a certain point, he was climbing up on his seat because the water was coming up higher and higher. And I think if he hadn't have been loaded down with as much stuff as he had, he probably would have floated away in the truck. But Wesley saved his life, and not because he just knew Dad, just because that's who Wesley is. And my wife wanted to send him a care package, and I said, well, I know he's got a lot of, you know, allergies to this and that and food sensitivities and stuff like that. And I said, I don't know if we need to send him all this other stuff. I said, but I've been thinking about it, and I really want to give him Granddaddy's rifle. And I mentioned it to Dad, and he said, I think that's a fine idea, because I have sons that probably won't appreciate what this means and what it is and where it came from as much as Wesley will. And I don't know that, I mean, me owning it, I'm never going to get it back to firing condition, nor would I even want to. I love it for the story. I love it for the history. I even like the brokenness of the fact that Dad wrote his name in it and trashed it as a kid, and like there's cracks in the wood. And but to somebody who really understands what this is and would appreciate it, it's almost worth having themselves just to hold it to go, I get it. I get it. And I think Wesley gets it. And I know he gets it. And so he's going to get it.
Okay.
So
that's all we'll say about that.
Big thank you.
You, I'm guessing you brought the bayonet.
I did bring the bayonet.
So let's pull it out, because I think the bayonet itself is quite impressive.
Where did I put it? Oh, here it is. The bayonet is still, by the way, razor sharp. Still, just as sharp as you could ask for.
And I've never sharpened that. That survived childhood with me without ever losing its edge. It's pretty amazing.
Still with the original inscriptions. I've looked these up on the internet.
Yeah.
This tells you where it was made, who it was made for.
Yeah.
And it still affixes to the front of the rifle.
Yeah.
And like we were talking about, you imagine the average Japanese soldier wasn't a very tall of stature man, but you can imagine this thing beside him and him entitled with using it, standing at attention, and then of course using it to kill the enemy. It's a heavy rifle.
It's heavy.
But life or death, and this is supposed to save your life, this is quite an instrument of destruction. So, to Wesley, thank you.
Thank you. Josh did talk to me about this. And here, you hold the camera.
Okay.
Josh did talk to me about this, and I totally agreed with him. I would rather see this in the hands of someone who knows how to take care of it than in the hands of someone who would let it go to the dump or something of that nature.
Or a pawn shop.
Anyway, Wesley, I'm delighted to have you have this. You're an awesome guy. We love you. Thanks.